has said the agency is an irredeemably flawed operation. The U.S. says it will find other ways to help Palestinian refugees. That's what Stephen Harper's conservatives did when they were in power.
Okay.
The Harper government cut off all Canadian aid to UNRWA in 2010, alleging that the terrorist group Hamas was siphoning off aid sent to UNRWA. Instead, the Harper government provided more than $90 million in aid directly to the Palestinian Authority, cutting out the UN agency. The Trudeau Liberals reversed that decision, though, and in 2016 provided $25 million to UNRWA, saying the UN was in the best position to help refugee women and children. The Trudeau government today would not comment on the U.S. decision, but a spokesperson for International Development Minister Marie-Claude Bibeau said Canada's funding came with enhanced due diligence to ensure that Canadian dollars were not misused or diverted to terrorist groups. So,
David, thank you.
You like David?
That was very good, David. Thank you.
Always thank you, David.
UNRWA.
UNRWA. Did you just push another button?
Check in with our weather specialist now, Patricia Jaggernaut. So map this out for us.
Okay.
When we have to dodge these rain drops.
Okay, well, really, raindrops, but also some thunderstorms rolling in. I have to say, there really is no organization in this system. So you really won't be running for too much cover over the course of this long weekend, especially in the here and now. We did see just a little speck of moisture. So warm, though, so much dried up here in the downtown core on ground level. And as we zoom out and take a look at satellite radar, you will overnight start to see again the re-entry of a couple cells, really weak in nature, but still important enough to mention. So through the morning hours, we will see the sun rise again and the clouds push in one more time with that heavy cloud deck. And then it will be more so about those sunny breaks for a big day on your Sunday, Monday. What about the cloudy side too? And yes, umbrella worthy, you will want to hold, especially if you are to the southwest watching us here in Toronto.
Unbelievable.
Stormy conditions, but look at that line right on the northern shorelines of Lake Erie. Going to be a little bit intense, and that's how we're rounding your long weekend. But back at home in Toronto, clear skies to get you out of this last official long weekend of summer 2018. You can see some of the storm watches are improving. Our friends through the Barrio, really, in the Skoka region are no longer under effect, of course, with the watches, but still down in southwest regions into extreme northern Ontario. So it really will be about that temperature story for this long weekend. 24 is where we should be. We are definitely nowhere.